All right, good morning everyone. Happy Thursday. You're on day four. You've stuck with me all week so far. I'm so proud of everyone. You are doing awesome. I've touched base with most of you already just to hear how things are going. I know I will still reach out to a few more of you before the week is out. So if there are any questions, you know how to reach me. I am here for you whenever you guys need. Today is butts and guts. That's right, folks. We're doing our core and our rear. So here's what you're going to need. If you you want a light set of dumbbells, you could do this entire workout body weight only, just as a reference. But if you do want to add a little bit of extra resistance, grab a dumbbell. Have a chair nearby for stability if you have any problems with doing lunges or squats. We'll have some modifications that require just holding onto a chair, edge of a couch, edge of a counter, if your balance isn't that great. And aside from that, have a good sense of humor. We're all in this together. So we'll give you guys just a couple of minutes to get started and we'll get right into it. I'm just going to let everybody run. Make sure your mats are out. Like I said, light set of dumbbells, a chair or a countertop nearby if you do need anything. Put your favorite playlist on in the background, and we'll get right into it. So 30 minutes of butts and guts is what we're going to be doing today. We will give it about 30 seconds, and we'll get straight into our warm-up, and we'll get going from there. Make sure you have your water nearby, if you need a towel for anything. Just have your area set. We'll be doing more repetition based today, so stick with me. If you can't keep up with the reps, go at your own pace. It's absolutely okay. Just do your best. Every week, remember, you get stronger with every single workout. So, all right, I think that's time. We're gonna jump right into it. So like we do every morning, we're gonna start with a warm up of the spine. So inhale those arms up, big breath in, arms overhead. Exhale, stretch over to the side. Inhale up, exhale, let's go to the other side. And up, now arms out to the side, chin to chest, roll all the way down. When you get to the bottom, do a squat, come right back up to the top. Again, over to the side, taking the side stretch here. Up and over, side stretch. Up back to the center, arms to the side, chin to chest, roll it down. You're gonna squat it down, roll it back up. Last time through, big breath in, over to the side. Inhale up, exhale over. Inhale up, arms to the side, chin to chest, rolling it down. You're gonna squat and come up. From here, we're just gonna do a few bodyweight squats, getting those legs primed, getting the glute muscles warmed up. We're gonna do 10 of these. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm gonna have you squat, reach to the side, squat, reach to the side, getting those rotational muscles warmed up. If the squat feels like too much with this, you could just do side reaches with that torso rotation. We'll do this for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now over the head, reach and reach. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good, arms out to the side, toes are wide. Engage those abdominal muscles. You could have a slight bend in the knee. We're gonna do toe crosses, reaching down and up. Down and up, go for 10. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then you're gonna have your arms out in front of you, and we're just gonna do some rotation, some gentle side twists, side to side, loosening the spine, getting everything in your center warmed up here. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's get straight into the workout. So we're going to start standing up and we're going to work our way down to the ground. First exercise is going to be to really hit those rears. We're going to do a curtsy lunge with a side kick, 10 on each side. So basically what this looks like is you're going to take your foot, cross it behind you, do a lunge down, kick it out to the side. So it's cross back, kick open, cross back, keep going with me. Now, if you are struggling with that motion, hold on to something for stability, and you can just take your leg, keep it straight, and do a little bit of a, you're just going to do a side leg lift. You're going to be hitting the same muscle group with your gluteus medius, which is going to target right here on the, kind of where those, you know, hip love handles hit. So we're going to be targeting that small muscle group on the top side of the butt. It also is really helping your hip flexor joints. So this is your modification. Let's get right into it. Starting with set of 10, cross it down and kick. 2, over, 3, over, 4, 5, I'll slow it down. I know not everyone can go as fast. 6, 7, really focus on your 4 more than anything. 8, kick, 9, kick, 10, whoop, find your balance, and kick. Now let's do the other leg. Crossing it back behind, kick it over to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If you want to add a level of resistance, you could hold dumbbells in your hand while you're doing this. That's 10. Second part of this is to hit our core. So here's where you'll pick up a light weight. Hold it into your hands, and we're going to do what you call a vertical climber. So here, you're going to have your weights up, and your arms are going to do this motion, while one leg is going to come in to meet it. So as I pull my right arm down, my right knee comes up, my left arm goes up. So we'll do 10 of these on the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good, we've got to change directions. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Really squeeze that oblique as you bring your knee to elbow here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic. We're going to go back to those curtsy lunges. Here we go. Take the leg, cross it over behind, lunge down, kick out. 2, out, 3, out, 4, out, 5, out, 6, out, 7, out, 8, 9, and 10. Good, let's change sides. Other leg crosses behind, find your balance to start. Take it down, kick it out. It's not uncommon to feel the burn in the supportive leg rather than the one you're kicking. Just means you're working hard and it's totally normal. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good, back to those vertical climbers. Here we go, weights up, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Change sides. 1, 2, 3. These are a lot harder than they look. Or maybe they look hard. I don't know. Always can feel my heart rate going up when I do these. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Set those weights down. Grab a sip of water. We're going to go into the next set. About 15 seconds off here. Now we're going to do a progressive set. So we're going to do 5 inchworms, followed by 10 Russian twists, 20 flutter kicks, and 30 bicycles. I'm going to count it out. I'm doing this with you. We're all in this together. Time to really focus on those cores. So coming for inchworms, here we go, starting at the back of your mat. And remember, you could just roll it down and walk it and roll it back up, or you could do the full walk out to the plank, whatever is right for your body. 5 inchworms, let's go. Walk it down, take it out to your plank, and walk it back up. Take it down, out, and up. It should go unsaid. Squeeze your core. Use those stomach muscles. This is all about strengthening these tummies. So as you're going down and up, squeeze it for stability. One more here. Taking it down and up, and come on down to your mat. We're gonna do Russian twists. You could do this with or without a weight. I'm gonna hold a single dumbbell here. And for the Russian twist, all you're gonna do is keep that weight closer to the body. Come over, tap it down side, lift up through the middle, tap it down on the other side. Let's keep going. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. See, easy, you've got this. Coming down to flutter kicks for 20. So lay back, hands underneath the hips, legs out in front, 20 little kicks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good, bring those knees in. Hands behind the head, and 30 bicycles. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Almost there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Roll yourself over to your side to press up, or just rock yourself all the way up. Grab a sip of water. We're going to do this whole thing again in 10 more seconds. Starting with inchworms. Back of your mat. Inchworms begin in 3, 2, 1. Let's roll it down and walk it out. 1. And back. 2. And back. 3. And back. 4. And up. Last one here. 5. And up. Come down to the mat. We're going into Russian twists. Find your weight. Find your balance. Weights up and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. On to flutter kicks. Laying flat, hands behind the hips for support. Legs out straight. Lift up the chin and the chest just a little bit off the floor to engage that core and flutter. 1, 2, 3. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Knees in. Hands behind the head. Bicycles begin now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Good job. Roll yourself up. Grab a sip of water. We're going to go into the next series. So we'll stay on the floor. We're going to go into bridges from here. So for the bridges, we are going to do three sets. What we'll look like is laying completely flat. Now, if you want to challenge yourself, you could put your feet up onto a chair, onto a stability ball, onto the edge of a duffel bag, anything to just give you a little bit of elevation. The movement will be the same regardless of whether you're doing it elevated or not. So what that will look like is you're going to press your lower back into the ground and then proceed to lift your hips, your lower back, your middle back, your upper back, all the way up until you can't lift anymore. Hold it with a squeeze and release the same way that you went in. We'll do 10 of these. Press it up again. All the way up for 2. And down. 3. And down. 4. And down. 5. And lower. 6. This is great for strengthening your lower abdominal muscles, your glutes, as well as your lower back muscles. So if you ever have any issues with sciatica or just low back pain, this is going to be a great way to strengthen it. 2 more here. On the last one, we're going to hold it up for 30 seconds. Here we go. On your marks, get set. Let's hold it up. Really focus on squeezing those glutes, driving the hips up toward the ceiling, keeping that core actively engaged. If you feel like you're starting to fall out, push into your heels and lift, squeeze a little bit more. Almost there. And lower down, that's 30. So grab your knees, give yourself a little hug to give a counter stress. We're going to do that 2 more times. Now, if you want to challenge yourself beyond having it elevated, you could do 1 of 2 more variations. You could either cross one leg over the other and do a lift so it looks like this, lifting it up. If you choose the one leg, focus on one leg for the hold. And the sets, and then on the next round, focus on your other leg so that you're balanced out. Alternatively, you could take one leg, lift it all the way up straight, and do your lifts this way. Same principle, if you're going to do the challenge move, focus on one leg on this round and the opposite leg on the other, and that's going to include holding those poses up. Here we go, round 2, press the lower back into the ground, lift it up 1, and down 2. Down, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 30 seconds is on my timer. Here we go, holding it up. I know those glutes are starting to burn. You're doing great. Push it up. Keep squeezing, squeezing, squeezing. Think about how beautiful the weather is going to be. Take your mind anywhere but on your butt. Time's up. Come out of there. Give your knees a gentle hug. We're going to do 1 more set. All right. Feet on the ground. Press that lower back in and lift. 1. And down. 2. And down. 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30 seconds on the clock. Hold it up. Go. Say the weather is supposed to be gorgeous. I would have taken you guys outside in the yard to work out this morning, but it is still only like 45 degrees out there. It's cold. But tomorrow morning it'll be beautiful, so maybe we'll do yoga on the patio. But this afternoon, sunny, warm. Think about a delicious salad that you could pack sitting out in your yard surrounded by beautiful flowers and fresh air, listening to the sound of the birds chirping. Lower it down. That's 30 seconds. Give those knees a gentle hug. See, when you think about other things, you're not even focused on lifting up in the air. Let's do the next series. So we're going to do some donkey kicks and fire hydrants. I'm going to show you the variations on these. So we'll start on hands and knees. And for the donkey kick, classic starting position is going to be here. You're going to bring the knee to chest and extend it out. So this will be our most basic move of it. If you want to take a challenge, you can take a dumbbell, squeeze it behind the knee. Now it's really important here, keep a flexed foot. It will actually help keep your foot and your leg from cramping up when you do this, but it also just keeps the weight in place a little bit better. So with the weight behind your knee, you'll do the press ups this way. You can also take a resistance band, should you want to use one, and just tie it around your thighs. And it will give you a level of resistance for both the donkey kicks and the fire hydrants. And all you have to do is keep it tied there and do nothing else. The band will do all the work on its own. So play around with the variations and see what feels right for you. And know that you could do it, you can rewind the video and replay this later if you wanted to try one or two of the things in a different variation. You have access to that. So we're gonna start with 10 fire hydrants, then we're going to do 10 donkey kicks, and then we're gonna do a straight leg crossover. We'll do it all three exercises on one side, then we're gonna sit back and stretch it out because your quads will be on fire, and then we're gonna do the other side and we'll repeat that whole set. So come into your starting position, leg up, and kick it up, and in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're going to take it out to the side, adjust the weight if you need to, or take it out from here. And the fire hydrants come out and in. 2, in, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10. So the next one I cannot do with the weight behind my leg, so I'll set that out. You're gonna take your leg straight out behind you, and you're gonna cross it to the opposite side of your supporting leg. Take it back up in the air, and cross it over. 3, cross, 4, cross, 5, cross, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. Come back to tabletop. Sit back into it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come up. Get ready for the other side. Put a weight behind your knee if that's how you're choosing to do this one. And begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Adjust that weight if you need to. We're taking it out to the side. Fire hydrants begin now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Take that weight out. Leg comes straight up behind you and cross it over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Knee back in, sit it down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna flip it over, come to a lying position on your mat. We're gonna do single leg crossover. So what that looks like is I'm gonna take my right leg and I'm gonna meet my left hand with it. So I'm gonna cross up and lower down. Cross it up and down, 10 on the same side. Keep going, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's go to the other side. Change arms, left arm, right leg. Take it up one. You could add a dumbbell into your hand for additional level of resistance here if you want to take it up a notch. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Now feet are going to be on the floor. Grab your dumbbell. You could do this body weight only if you want. If you're holding a dumbbell, hold it with both hands. And we're going to do a little weight to sit up. Taking it up, lowering it down with control, bringing the arms over your head. Now you don't have to stretch all the way flat. I realize that the shoulders for a lot of people are really challenged to bring that weight all the way over their head. So if you want to stop it right here, that is absolutely okay. Let's keep going. 2, and up, 3, and back, 4, back, 5, back, 6, back, 7, back, 8, back, 9, and 10. Great job. Set that weight aside. We're gonna come back to tabletop, grab a quick sip of water. 15 more seconds, we're gonna start that whole series one more time, starting with the donkey kicks again. Everyone's still doing okay? You guys are working hard. I know it. These are not easy moves, but stick with it. Do what you can and just go at your own pace. All right, let's get right back into this. We're gonna take it, grab the weight behind your leg if you want it here. Otherwise, hands and knees, donkey kicks begin now. Knee in and out. 2, out, 3, out, 4, out, 5, out, 6. Really try to focus on getting that leg a little lift up, just to extra boost on the bottom. 2 more. And taking it out to fire hydrant. Side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And crossovers, leg out straight, crossing it down. 1, 2, up, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. Sit back into it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Other side. Donkey kicks. Take it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and over to fire hydrants. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now take that leg straight, cross it down, and out. 2, 3, 4,
five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10.
Good. Sit back into it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Come onto your back. We're going to do that same set of core crossover. So laying flat, right arm, left leg, take it up for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's change sides. If you've had a lot of water this morning, you're probably feeling it and hearing it swoosh around in your stomach. Nothing wrong with that. Just eating and digestion. Keeping everything moving. Water is good for you. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. You're gonna grab that weight. Let's do the last set of 10 weighted sit-ups here, and let's lift it up. 1, back, 2, back, 3, back, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good, set that weight down. We're gonna do one last little series, one time through. So this is gonna be a double leg pull, which is a Pilates move. And then we're also gonna do a roll up to balance. So let's get right into it. You're gonna come onto your back, legs come up, take them and scissor them out. Grab a hold of the back of one calf, give it a little double pull and change. Double pull and change. Here's two, we're gonna do 10 on each side. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now bring those knees in. You're gonna give yourself a gentle little rock here to give yourself some momentum. And you're gonna rock it up and hold and rock it back. Up and hold and back. We're going for 10. 3, and back, 4, back, 5, and back, 6, and back, 7, and back, 8, and back, 9, and back, 10. Come all the way up to a standing position. You don't have to just roll up. If you needed to stand up on your own, totally fine. From here, take a wide stance. Pulse it down. You're gonna hold it here. Just hold it for a minute. You guys did amazing today. You're gonna take a little pulse here. Pulsing it out for 30 seconds, holding and pulsing. This is the last move of the day. Pulse, pulse, pulse. How are you guys feeling? You're feeling strong with those cores? Your rears might feel a little jello later. Totally normal. You're working hard, you're doing great. Keep it going, drop it down a little lower. Pulse, 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 pulse. Finishing strong, this is the last move, you're doing great. We're gonna hold this for 10 more seconds. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Straighten those legs. Now do a big stretch up. Stretch through the abs. Just open, 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 open. Take it over to the side. And then let's put a bend in your knee. You're going to take those arms. You're going to roll them to a circle all the way down, nice and controlled and around. And come up. Bend in the knees again. Circle the other way. And up. Come back to the center. One more. Reach up, 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 up. Big breath in. Exhale, hands to heart center. You guys killed it today. I'm so proud of you. Awesome job. Tomorrow is yoga day. We'll do a great 30-35 minute practice. So have water, mat, a blanket, any kind of prop that you might need, like a towel. A towel would be really good to bring tomorrow, just for balance poses. It'll help if you don't have the flexibility to reach all the way down, for example, to your foot. You can wrap the towel around and it'll give us a little leverage. Or if you have a yoga strap, this would be the time to bring it out. Great job, like I said, and I look forward to sharing our workout again tomorrow morning. Have a great day, everyone.